Good morning, children. So let's learn class 7th lesson, nutrition in living organisms. So in that lesson, we learn types of nutrition in plants and animals. So let's write question answers. First, question number 1 and question number 2, both are homework. Now, write question number 3rd. First question, why do living organisms, need nutrition? Question is, why do living organisms need nutrition? Answer, living organism need nutrition due to the following. Number A, to supply the energy required for drinking water. Then C, for growth and development of body, then third point is C, to replace the damaged cells and repair tissues to fight disease, and D, to fight disease. Okay, write down this answer. So living organisms need nutrition due to following: to supply the energy required for doing work, for growth and development of body, and C, to replace the damaged cells and repair tissues, and to fight diseases. So this is the answer. Then next question B. Explain the process of photosynthesis. Explain the process of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis or production of food in plant. Process of production of food. In plants. Answer. So the production of food process is a photosynthesis. Green plants can produce. Green plants can produce their own food, with the help of sunlight and chlorophyll. Own food in their leaves. Water and using water and nutrients from the soil. And carbon dioxide, that is CO2, from the air. The process is called photosynthesis. Okay. In this process, plants give out plants give out oxygen and take in carbon dioxide and take in CO2, that is carbon dioxide. This is the process of photosynthesis. So let's write down the reaction. It is a chemical process. So let's write down reaction of this process. But reaction is important. So in that 6 CO2 plus 6 H2O then formation of C6H12O6 plus 6O2. So here it is carbon dioxide plus this H2O is the water. That reaction carried out in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll pigment. Chlorophyll pigment is necessary. Then C6H12O6, that is the food formation, that is the glucose is food, means glucose and plus oxygen release. Oxygen gas released in the process of photosynthesis. Okay. So this is the reaction. Write down this. Note down. Then next question. Next question is, what is meant by parasitic plants? Question 3. What is meant by parasitic plants? Mean by parasitic plants. Okay, name their different types. Name their different in their different types. Okay. Answer. Parasitic plant means the plants that grow the plants that grow on the body of other, on the body of other plants to obtain to obtain food or water. Are called parasitic plants. Then, examples, there are two types of parasitic plants. There are two types of plants. Okay. Holoparasites. That is Rafflesiaceae, and any parasitic. Hemiparasitis, that is Lorenthes. Okay, then write down next question. B. Question B. Explain the various steps of nutrition in animals. Explain the various steps of nutrition in animals. Various steps are as follows. One is ingestion. Ingestion, okay? Food is taken into the body. Food is taken into the body. into the body, that is ingestion. Second step is digestion. Digestion, conversion of conversion of food into simple soluble form. Okay, then third step, that is absorption. Absorption, what happened in absorption? Transfer of soluble food into the blood. Okay. Then fourth is assimilation. Assimilation step. What happened in that? Utilization of absorbed food. Utilization of absorbed food. Utilization of absorbed food by cells and tissues. And tissues for energy production. Okay, so very important stages. Then the last step, that is ejection. Ejection, so removal of waste here takes place. Removal of waste. Removal of waste from body. Okay, so these are the five different stages of nutrition in animals. Okay, children. So you revise the question answers. Question number one and question number two, both are homework for you. So bye, everyone. Next period, we will continue the remaining question answers.